toast to their career.
The perfect combination, boy.
Legends in the South.
This is sports fans' only home for the hottest sports show around. These guys are on fire.
You're now listening to KJ and Sean Mack.
Thanks for tuning in to Sports Fans Only Boxing. C. Anthony back with another video. Today on deck, Adrian Broner versus Giovanni Santiago. You know, punch stats, 207 landed versus 98. So we all know who won, right? Wrong. This was an okay fight. I can't say it was a good fight, a great fight. It was it's really good to see Adrian Broner back in the ring again. I believe it's the first time in 2 years he's been in the ring, and I think that he hasn't won. First time he's actually won in 4 years. So I'll get started with this. I'll say that late in that fight, Adrian Broner, he stepped up a little bit. He started to look a little bit sharp, started to use his jab a little bit more. Check hook was on point, starting to land a little bit more and more. As I would say, after the seventh round, looked like he kind of shook off the ring rust, which I'm sure he had a lot of it, like I was saying, fighting. First fight in about 2 years, you know, he stayed on the ropes a lot in the first in the first six rounds. I would say he didn't move around, so he was an easy target versus Giovanni. We all know Giovanni's a come forward power puncher, likes to attack the body, appendix, liver, all that area right there. So I'll say, you know, Adrian Broner got the win. I scored the fight differently. A lot of other people in the sport, like, you know, actual boxers, Shakur Stevens, DeCharlos, they all kind of felt that this was a robbery. I'm not saying that it was a robbery. Hats off to Adrian Broner, congratulations. But I felt like this was, it was unanimous, all three judges. Definitely didn't look like that. I watched the fight like three times. I actually watched it again this morning, the whole fight, at about 7 o'clock. So I'll say Santiago, he's 31. That was his first loss. I believe he was 14-0. Adrian Broner's 31, but the difference with Adrian Broner, he's a high mileage 31-year-old. He's not like, you know, he's more like rounding out toward the back end of his career rather than progressing and being sharp and being like at the pinnacle of like where he needs to be. I'll take this back, you know, Adrian Broner at one point before 2013 was considered the second coming of Floyd Mayweather, and it's so weird because when I used to hear it back then, I didn't say anything because Adrian Broner looked really, really good. He used to really let his hands go. He's when he's trying to attack, Adrian Broner can really put the pressure on. A lot of good, you know, he has a lot of speed, real, real flashy. You know, he does have some power. He did drop Sean Porter with that check hook. Even Santiago, he almost got the knockdown. You know, the balance of Santiago was real, real good. But Adrian Broner, he does have the power. But seems like at the 147 division, I'm starting to feel like he's already progressed to as high as he can go in the sport under these conditions. His conditioning isn't the best. It seems like at 147, he doesn't have the power to really hurt people. He stayed in that fight, and he did step up, like I said, the second half of the fight. But ever since 2013, Adrian Broner has been different. Seemed like the Madonna fight way back, I keep bringing up it, it took away his confidence. He became gun-shy. That's the word I was looking for. He became gun-shy and kind of like, you know, his conditioning is off. So it seems like in the beginning of the fight, he tries to size you up and fight for six rounds without really pressing because he knows he doesn't have the condition. Then after the sixth round, he kind of gets on the front foot and push. So I don't know where Adrian Broner goes from here because at 147, I don't think he's ready for any of the elite-level competition. I don't even think he's ready for, like, Thurman. Definitely Sean Porter, Errol Spence, Terrence Crawford, none of those guys. But maybe he needs to go back to 140. But at 140, I'm not going to run off through the list of names. But there's a lot of good competition there for Adrian Broner. So I'm not sure where he can go from now. Like exactly what's he looking for? He did make some statements after the fight, which I don't know what to think of it. But he never said that his eyes is on the prize. He's trying to get the title or anything. He's more or less talking about just staying busy and if he can stay busy, he'll stay out of trouble. I know he had some financial things, but I don't know what he really wants out of the sport now. Like I said, he's like a older, maturing 31-year-old. I'm starting to feel like maybe it was a robbery. I'm not saying it, but I definitely had that fight score different. 207 to 98 with the output. So that's like 2-1. I believe in three categories, Santiago, and the body shots and the jabs and power punches, I believe. Well, I'm quite sure he doubled up Adrian Broner's numbers. So this was a strange fight, but Adrian Broner got the win. A lot of diehard Adrian Broner fans out there, so I know they'll take the win. It's another fight for him. Hopefully, we can get like two or three more fights from him this year. Hopefully, you know, maybe he can run it against Keith Thurman. I think that'd be a good fight for the fans to see, because just the way the contrast in styles with those two, and it's time for Keith to get back in the ring also. So I'm gonna say, like, you know, shouts out to Adrian Broner. Santiago, he's going to be there. But Broner, from here on out, I don't know where he goes. Congratulations on the victory. But from here on out, if he fights, he got to let the hands go. He got to get busy from the beginning. And hopefully he can get back to some top-notch competition and maybe get some of these big pay-per-view fights and fight some of the top-notch competition. So I would say from here on out, going to step up with a lot more videos coming soon. I'll be back Sunday with another video. A lot of excitement coming up in the sport. So I'll see you soon. Stay tuned to Sports Fans Only Boxing. See Anthony back with another video. Sean Mack on production. Peace.